I'll show you a small trick to make Windows larger. Usually you have a limit on changing font size in items. For example, Active Title Bar has maximum point size of 24 points for fonts and maximum limit of 400 pixels for the item itself. However, that's not the final limit. It can be bigger than that by simply entering the font size manually up to whatever value range was on the kind of data type that was used in these controls. As far as it seems, now we have a giant taskbar, but we need a bigger one. There's also a glitch where item size goes over the maximum value when you try to decrease the item size. In this case, the active title bar is going up to 162 pixels. And now I'll increase every single option in here up to nearly usable levels. Title bar should be at 162 pixels. Minimum borders up to 50 pixels. Icons up to 72 pixels. Horizontal spacing up to 150 pixels. Vertical spacing up to 150 pixels. Inactive title bar and border are same as active ones. Menu up to 100 pixels. Message box font up size up to 100 points. Palette title also up to 100 points. Scroll bars up to 100 pixels. And finally, tooltips font size up to 100 points. Now we have a quite big Windows desktop. The good thing is that this is on Full HD resolution or you won't be able to see a thing. As you can see, it's still usable apart from the text being nearly impossible to read and some controls being overlapped. The Explorer interface is being overlapped by a status bar and menu switch ends up with not even a single trace of folder content. At least by turning off toolbars you are able to explore at some point. The file names are giant, icons are large, but it's not so easy to read. Not enough for you? Are you far-sighted? My serious apologies if you are. I'll probably get short-sighted soon if that makes you anyhow better. Well then, we can increase text size up to 500% by simply changing the DPI, that's dots per inch. As you can see the dialog, you probably know the consequences of increasing this even further. I'll just put taskbar on auto height to avoid filling the whole screen with it. Waiting for the reboot. And now we have a nearly broken login window. Title is big enough to fit the whole screen, and it also makes that nice glitchy effect on the side. Most likely the title bar is rendering is out of range. And after we log in and skip a few seconds of long login process, we get text over the whole screen, nearly filling the wallpaper with itself. Tooltips can be still read, but icons probably not. I don't think we are able to see what's in my computer this time. The bottom thing is most likely the status bar, and the top is the title bar. It's difficult to manage the window because for some reason it goes to the desktop. Also, you may notice a glitch during its size animations. You can still see the bottom right corner of the window where you can resize the actual window for a bit. That's where it seems to be screwed up. I'm trying to open stat menu, but instead it resizes it in a way that the only thing that remains is a clock in this case. With some luck, I'm able to move the taskbar to a side where it doesn't fill the whole space. Even though you can open the start menu, you can't see what's in it. At least it's possible to shut it down, but not yet. Even if I try to reopen my computer, it's basically impossible to use as it keeps disappearing when I try to interact with it. Opening my documents gives noticeable borders to the window, but if you maximize it, hell appears with the glitched animation and giant tooltips of window actions that keep appearing all over. And finally, we'll check Outlook, where you can still see a normal splash screen, while everything else is once again impossible to interact with. If you want to try this, it will probably work only on versions older than Vista. I tried it on 98 second edition and XP. That's it. Bye.